And good afternoon, YouTube community, guys and girls. It's me, your boy, Lex Anderson. It's Thursday afternoon, which means I'm here to lay the knowledge on terms of my predictions for week 3 of the NFL season. First things first and foremost, representing the Yankees, pinstripe pride, hashtag Bronx Bombers, hashtag pinstripe pride, hashtag Yankees universe. And I would like to first offer my condolences and prayers to the young girl, 3 years old, who was hit by a line drive yesterday in her face. From what I read in the New York Times, it came off the bat at 106 miles an hour. You know, I would have preferred to have been talking about how Dee Gregorius has surpassed Derek Jeter for most home runs by a Yankee shortstop with 25. Aaron Judge, Gary Sanchez, going back to back. Aaron Judge leading the AL with now 45 home runs on the year as the Yankees complete the sweep of the Minnesota Twins. But I can't really revel in that too much. I'm just putting out the stats, obviously. But as a New Yorker, knowing that there are a lot of obnoxious New Yorkers who feel that because they pay such a high price for things, that they want things their way. So I'm just here to address the issue of safety, that there needs to be more netting, obviously. You know, there are plenty of signs all over the place that you have to be aware of the balls and bats coming into the seats. And that's what happened, unfortunately. This is not the first incident at Yankee Stadium. This is the third, and it's definitely the third one involving a child. So, you know, to the Yankee fans who feel that because they pay between $500 and $2,500, you heard that correct, $2,500 for one ticket behind home plate or in the cushy leather seats in their suite area, it's time to put an importance on safety. So once again, my prayers go out to that little girl, wishing her a speedy recovery in regards to what had happened yesterday. Okay. So, let's get to the games and my predictions. I thought I had a horrible week too, but it really wasn't that bad, but it could have been better. So, I got some research going on. Let's just go through what I got right now. And what I have is Thursday night, Rams at 49ers. Statistically, the 49ers own the Rams and are currently 3-0 against them. But I'm gonna go with the Rams to take this game on Thursday night with the special color uniforms. So let's go LA Rams. Okay, let's go with the Sunday games. Ravens at Jaguars. We already talked about it. The Ravens defense is playing out of this world right now. Or actually, they're playing at the level that they're used to playing. Stifling defense that will suffocate you. And Blake Bortles, you know, the kid's a turnover waiting to happen. Or I should say waiting to throw. So look for the Ravens to go to get over to Jaguars in this one. And I see it's a 9:30 a.m. start, so it looks to be an international game abroad. Thankfully, I have Sunday off, so I will set the alarm to tune in. Or actually, I won't set the alarm. I'll just wake up when I wake up and catch the game. Okay, the 1 o'clock games. Browns at Colts. Whew. Two teams that both suck. Well, I'm going to say that the Colts get the win on this one. Giants at Eagles. I'm going to say the Giants only if Odell Beckham Jr. is playing. If Odell Beckham Jr. is not playing, you could look for this to be an Eagles victory because Wentz is definitely stepping up his game and his quarterback play is very impressive as of late. Dolphins at Jets. You know, there was an article on SportsCenter, or ESPN I should say, about how the Jets potentially have a chance to go 0-16 on the season. I'm going to say that that trip to NFL infamy will continue because the Dolphins will be beating the Jets. Broncos at Bills. Well, after what the Broncos did to the Cowboys, I'm sure they should have no issue handling the Bills out there in Ralph Wilson Stadium. Saints at Panthers. This game has me very conflicted because the Panthers last week, it was pretty much a field goal game. Drew Brees and the Saints can't win on the road, but Drew Brees has more firepower at his disposal. So I'm going to go with the Saints on this one. Steelers at Bears. We know what's gonna happen. Antonio Brown, Big Ben, that other wide receiver I had mentioned, Bryant, Le'Veon Bell. Look for the Steelers to topple the Bears at home. Falcons at Lions. Wow. Woo. This is a tough one because it's a road game, but the Falcons have that high-powered offense. And let's face it, folks, the Falcons are on a revenge tour to get back to the playoffs, to get back to the Super Bowl. And one of those 2 days is not going to happen. The Falcons are probably going to get to the playoffs. They might get to the Super Bowl, but I'm still going to label them as Super Bowl pretenders. So let the revenge tour continue. I'm going to go with the Falcons on this one. Tampa Bay Buccaneers at Vikings. Sam Bradford puts up good numbers if you're a fantasy owner, but on the downside, he's injury prone. If he's not suiting up, the Vikings don't have a chance, and the Buccaneers, like I said, their defense is scary. It's Super Bowl caliber defense. I'm gonna go with the Bucs to beat the Vikings. Texans at Patriots. Yeah, I last recall that twice the Texans season ended in the playoffs at the hands of the Patriots. So why should anything change in the regular season? And the Patriots have shown that with or without Gronkowski, or Gronk as everybody calls him, they can get the job done. So let's go with New England to, humiliate the Texans. 4-5 game. This will be my upset game of the week. And of course there is bias on it because I am a Tennessee Titans fan. Seahawks at Titans. Marcus Mariota. This is the game that you need to prove to me that you are not just the quarterback for the Tennessee Titans, but to prove that you can try to take the next step to being an elite quarterback in the NFL. Because Mariota, he's a good quarterback, but let's face it, he's not elite. But you could prove that you have the ability to be elite by beating the Seahawks in your house, especially with the kind of defense that the Seahawks bring to the table. And especially after Richard Sherman said that it is up to the defense to carry the team to victory. So if I was Mariota, I would definitely be spending an overnight stay at the team facility dissecting their defense. You've been forewarned. Bengals at Packers. The Bengals suck. They're 0-2, still haven't scored a touchdown. And if Andy Dalton can't beat the Texans with a backup QB making his first start and getting a victory, do you expect me to believe that the Bengals can go into Green Bay and beat discount double check Aaron Rodgers? The answer is a resounding no. Look for the Green Bay Packers to take that game. Chiefs at Chargers. Great rivalry game. You can be sure that potentially these teams are going to light it up. But you know who's been lighting it up? Rookie phenom Hunt. Kelce is pretty much manhandling and pushing to the side anyone who thinks they can try to tackle him in the open field. You have Alex Smith, very efficient, very smart, very versatile, and he can run, if need be, to get that third down. I'm going to go with the Chiefs on that one. Oh, and by the way, previously I'm going to go with the Titans to beat the Seahawks as my upset game. I was going to make Chiefs and Chargers, but I think the Chiefs have this one, so I believe in Kansas City. Okay, the Sunday night game. Woo! Raiders at Redskins. Derek Carr has been given job security. He's been given a long-term contract with a lot of money on it. I believe to the tune of, what, $120 million, right? $65 million guaranteed? Then you have Cousins, who's been franchised for the last 2 seasons. But in those last 2 seasons, he's been franchised for a very good amount of money. I mean, like, come on, let's face it, folks. Cousins has made at least over $50 million in guaranteed money. So let's stop acting like Kirk Cousins should be so insulted that the Redskins haven't given him that dream $100 million contract. I'm going to express my opinion and say that it does bother Cousins that he doesn't have a long-term contract, despite pocketing over nearly $50 billion in NFL guaranteed money. And it will show when they lose to the Raiders on Sunday Night Football. And what do we have here? Monday Night Football, Cowboys at Cardinals. The Cowboys have a lot to prove. Because after what happened last week, and I get it, it's 16 games. No one's going to have a perfect regular season, but the Cowboys got dismantled. LaDainian Tomlinson called out Ezekiel Elliott saying he quit on his team. So the bright lights are on, folks. Monday Night Football, when the entire nation sits down at their sports bar or in their living room or their den or their man cave. So Ezekiel Elliott, I, Mr. Anderson, am challenging you to put forth the performance of a lifetime. I'm going to say that Ezekiel Elliott is going to carry the team to victory. Look for the Cowboys to beat the Cardinals in their nice, artistic stadium. So that is all I have in regards to the NFL season. And of course, you know, I can't go without representing the O, the University of Oregon. Go, hashtag, go Ducks, taking on Arizona State Saturday night at 10 p.m. on the Pac-12 channel. I will be there watching that game. So definitely I look forward to seeing how many more points that the Oregon Ducks could stomp out on the hapless Arizona State. But however, as a fan, I do have to voice my concern with the lack of scoring in the second half. Don't get me wrong, it's great seeing a team light it up for like 40 plus points in the first half, but scoring only a touchdown or two in the second half and leaving it to your defense, don't get me wrong, it's great to see that the Ducks have great defense to go with great offense. Let's just get a couple more scores. I'm not asking for 70 point games every week. And they are winning. Let's face it, right? A win is a win. And let's go, Ducks. Just keep on winning, especially since Arizona State is unranked. So they should get thrashed really good. It'll be fast and furious. And it'll probably be an easy win. But let me know. I don't want to discount them, but hey, the numbers don't lie. And speaking of don't lie, numbers don't lie. I'm at over 100 subscribers, and I would like to first and foremost thank you guys and girls of the YouTube community for not only viewing my videos, but for subscribing so you can see more videos. And I thank you very much, each and every one of you that has tuned in to watch my videos. And you know what? Things are only going to get better from here, folks. We have no ceiling, baby. The sky is truly the limit. And once again, I'd like to thank you guys and girls for supporting me, putting out these great videos with sports and life in general. Because you know what? Without you, there is no me. And from the bottom of my heart, I sincerely and truly thank everybody. Special shout out to the people from abroad checking me out over there in Great Britain. Salutes to each and every one of you. That is all I have for today. I'm gonna go home and enjoy my chopped salad with my girlfriend and take a little nap and get ready for this Thursday night football game. So, until next time, YouTube community, guys and girls, this is your boy Lex Anderson. I'm signing out.